Hi everybody, this is Victoria from Blue Hand Arts. Today I'm going to paint for this orchid, Chinese orchid. It's a Cymbidium family. It's called the Sinensis or Sinensis. In Chinese, Mo Lan. Mo means ink, Lan means orchid. See this flower? It's very dark. However, some are lighter color, lighter green, and like a white, yellowish thing. And the leaf is kind of a dark green and tough, but wide. See the width? It's pretty wide. And there are two spikes and some flower. And the flower petal is still like a three outsider and the two arm embracing, holding towards. But this kind of flower, the outside petal is kind of very opened and kind of bent back, kind of this. So. And the paper I'm going to use today is the mulberry paper, the made from the mulberry tree bark fiber, nothing to do with the fruits. I'm using the way of the outline to do the orchids, and later you will see the inside. I will just leave this green. I do not put the green to fill in the outline thing. That's why I choose this blue color and with some golden flake. Of course, ink and the brush I use is this liner. So see, it's long. Center is the stiff hair, the bristle, and outsider. So the stiff hair for like the maintain the shape is harder, and outside is the soft like sheep goat hair for maintain holding more water like a reservoir. So this combination brush of a liner, the more. Water soft outside is for holding more ink, and I can do the longer liner stroke. See the leaves, not the same length, some shorter, like two lengths at least, some shorter, the new shoots, new growth, shorter and straight. And this kind of not that much bend because it's very wide. So a little bit gesture and most not bend, not very curly. So I use ink to do the outline. I will do the some short one first in front. And then, because this kind of the style, I can only do like the interweaving thing. So I will do some short one first. See the shorter one and the other one. Okay, some shorter one already. And later, I'll do some different length, the longer one. we say for the arrange for the structure of the orchid's leaf, we need to do some crossing and make the phoenix eye, right? Some crossing thing and some breaking phoenix eye thing. So eventually, so some crossing and some breaking the phoenix eye. So eventually we will see some eyes. See some a little bit of bend things at the top. Some twist leaves. Okay, then I will do the spike thing. This spike and the flower, I will use the Chinese watercolor rouge. I used the harder bristle, the wolf one, actually, a stiff bristle one to do the spike. And the flower later, I will choose the soft brush. Straight and not very stiff. Okay, then I will do flower. See, flower towards different directions and some about like the back and like a back and across this spike. So I just do some xieyi, not copy it one by one. Some still on top, still butt there. Yeah, something. And some butter. Halfway open with some see-through thing. Mulberry paper, kind of a semi-sized, so actually not very absorbent, some semi-absorbent, so need lots of color ink. And a little spike connect the flower and the main spike. I don't do very detailed things on this kind of thing. I'm just a hint of some strokes. Okay, and for the flower center, there is some yellow dots here indicate like a nose, and some red dots beside the yellow one. Some use Chinese watercolor yellow. Do some dental thing. That's enough. So it's halfway dry. Just see. So I don't worry about a little bit of smearing. That's the effects of Chinese painting. And this is Xie Yi painting. Halfway opened, does really see the hole, I mean the yellow thing. Not that sure. And then beside the yellow one, some red, very dark dotted. Yeah, that's about it. And the bottom, actually, some because I outside, normally I put some grass there, and this clay pot. The media I use is some tree barks and see the little tree barks, and some pumice, the little rock, and some potting mix. So keep the moisture and let it breathing. So do I want to do some potting thing? Probably here I want a little bit more thing. Yeah, I can always add thing. Actually, there are some like a vein thing on the leaf. Yeah, very small thing. Do I want to do that just to show some probably. Something's not very defined. Cannot very see that clear. I think that's about it. And the I will do some part. Yeah, there is the orchid carved thing on the pot. Some grass. and some medium kebabs. Okay, that's it, and I will write the name Mo Lan, Ink Orchid, right here. Hope you can see it. More here is Lan. Here I'm going to put my name. The year of the rest. Chinese lunar year. Genzi. And then my name. Right. And name chop. Ink paste. Make sure got the color each corner, and I use this rubber band, or you know, can use piece of the catalog or magazine something underneath. Yeah, you can press. Okay, put down first, and then press. You know, make sure each corner, like every stroke shows touched the paper. And then one hand hold the paper and gently lift it. Done. This is my painting today on rice paper with color, with gold flakes for this sinus or sinus Chinese orchid. Mo Lan, ink orchid. Okay, very, very fragrant. So I like to do that, and for my like kind of a calligraphic practicing. I will do more when I got inspiration of the flower opening, blooming. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.